Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Diamond, your favorite social media manager, giving business owners tips on how to build their brand using influencer marketing. And in today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you different ways that you can use influencers for your Black Friday sale. So you may be wondering why it's a good idea to use influencers for your Black Friday sale. And the main reason is because people are looking for trusted recommendations. They're looking for advice on what gifts to buy. You know, it is not called the holiday rush for no reason, right? It is a busy and stressful time of year, so people are going to be looking towards the influencers that they trust the most to recommend really good product and gift ideas during this time. And that's because people buy from people. They want somebody who they can relate to, just giving them recommendations like their friends or family would. They don't really want to be sold to in the traditional sense. They want to feel like they have a connection with somebody, and it's just a friend telling them, hey, I love this product and I think you would too. So now that we've talked about why it's a good idea to use influencers for your Black Friday sale, let's get into how you can plan the Black Friday influencer campaign up for success. And my number one tip is to start early. Just like this time of year is super busy for business owners and regular consumers, it is also a really busy time for influencers. You will notice an uptake in the amount of holiday influencer campaigns that are being pushed out at this time. And it's because a lot of larger brands understand the power that influencer marketing can have on their business and sales goals at this time. Influencers are really busy right now too. They're getting approached by different brands about different partnerships, and they really have the kind of, you know, right to be picky about the brands that they work with. So if you know that there's an influencer that you really want to work with, I would suggest reaching out to them really early in advance in order to solidify the partnership. Now, speaking about finding the right influencer for your brand, I do have a video all about how you can find the right influencer for your brand. So I'll link that here and in the description box below. But for the sake of this video, I'm just going to give you some key insights that you can look for in order to make sure that it's a good partnership. So some key insights that you want to look for is their audience demographics. So you want to make sure that their audience is similar to yours. That way they're a warm audience. They're more likely to like your product and buy it. You want to look at their engagement rate. So you want to make sure that their audience is already engaged with their normal organic content. That means that they'll be more likely to be engaged and connect with sponsored posts. And the last thing you want to look at is their past partnership performances. That's some good alliteration. And so what this means is that you want to approach the influencer, and some of them will have case studies from previous brand partnerships that they've done, and you want to just kind of see what kind of results were they able to get. Now, you do want to take it with a grain of salt, because of course there are so many variables that go into what leads to a successful campaign. But if you can see different case studies from the influencer, that kind of gives you a sense of if they have a good track record of giving results or if they're not so good, and then you may want to pass on the partnership. Now, another thing that you want to have to set the campaign up for success is a campaign brief. Now, a campaign brief is just a document that outlines some details about your brand, the product, any campaign guidelines, or content expectations. It really just outlines everything that the influencer needs to know about the current campaign in one document. Now, you may be thinking, why do I need to do this? That seems a little extra and overkill, but it's not. It's actually a really good resource to have and to give the influencers, because one, you do not want an influencer to have to comb through a bunch of emails in order to find some key vital information that they need about your product. If there is something specific that they're supposed to say about your product, then you don't want to have that buried in a bunch of emails. Another good pro tip is that if you can splurge, I would suggest doing expedited shipping in order for the influencer to get the product on time, have time to use it, and have a good amount of time to create that quality content, so they're not feeling rushed in order to have it by a certain deadline. Okay, so now that we have all the planning out the way, we're gonna jump into the first way that you can actually use influencers for your Black Friday sale. And this is by using tutorial style content or solution-based content. This type of content serves as a visual representation to your audience, and it showcases why they need your product and how it solves a problem they're having. It helps to really cut down on any doubt or hesitation they have when making a purchasing decision, because if they can see how it solves the specific problem they're having, they're more likely to buy it. So an example of tutorial-style content, let's say that you are a home decor brand. So you have really nice linens and platters, you make really cool vases, and you have nice utensils, all that good stuff. And you work with an influencer who creates a tutorial-style content of them using your home decor products to create a nice tablescape. And a tablescape is just a fancy word for setting up a table for a nice dinner. So for Friendsgiving or Thanksgiving, they're going to be showing themselves setting up their table using your products. So they have your nice napkins, your nice cloth napkins all set up and nice with like a napkin ring. And they're using your platters to display the food. They did really nice centerpieces with the vases that you have. And, you know, they have the curtains on the windows. And it just sets up a nice scene where the audience can really see, wow, maybe I do need that vase. I would love to do a centerpiece like that. You know, oh, that platter looks really good. That little gravy boat is something I definitely need. It tells a story of how your products can be integrated into your target audience's lifestyle without actually like selling to them. Now, the second way that you can use influencers for your Black Friday sale is, I could not think of like a good name for this one, but it's really just using an exclusive coupon code. So let me explain this one, because this one is a really good one that I don't think a lot of brands utilize enough. And so what happens is that there are some people who miss Black Friday sales and Cyber Monday sales. There are people, me, it's me, I am people, people is me. And so with having an exclusive coupon code, you are becoming the savior of the day. Like, your brand is the savior of the day. So what you're gonna do is, about a week or two after Black Friday, you're gonna have another Black Friday sale. It's going to be like a late shoppers, you missed it, but you didn't really miss it sale. And so what you're gonna do is, you're gonna partner with different influencers. You're going to have them create some content promoting your products. And on top of that, you're going to offer their audience an exclusive coupon code. Like, there's like some psychology around that people like to be a part of something that other people aren't a part of. Like, it's like an exclusive, that's just gonna be the word. It's like an exclusive club, you know, like, ooh, only we have theirs. And I'll tell you where I got this idea. So I mainly work with product-based businesses, and so they run sales periodically. And I have this one client, and in her stories right after the sale, I will ask her audience, hey, did you take advantage of this sale that we just had? Some people say yes. And then, you know what happens? We get a whole flood of DMs from people saying, no, I missed the sale. Oh my gosh, when are you having another one? Please have another one. I missed it. And this happens a lot. This happens after every sale that she has, that other clients have had. And it kind of just dawned on me. And so trust me, people are going to miss your Black Friday sale, and they are going to want to participate in this exclusive late shoppers sale that you're having. Just trust me on it. Now, the next way that you can use influencers for your Black Friday sale is with affiliate marketing. And so if you don't know, affiliate marketing is really just when you partner with different influencers who promote your products. And if somebody uses the specific link that you give to them, then the influencer can earn a percentage of the sales from that purchase. And so it's really simple, easy. It's been around for a while now, and a lot of influencers participate in it. And you'll see that it's an easy way to boost your sales while giving the influencer an incentive to promote the product. So this one is a good one. If you don't really want to go through the whole process of planning a campaign, this is something that's kind of just evergreen. You set it up and you kind of just let it run its course. It's also really good because it seems very organic. And so I'm sure you've seen this before, and if you're watching an influencer stories, 9 times out of 10, if they are using a product and they have an affiliate link for it, they will promote that link. They will say, hey, I love this product. You can click this link and purchase it for yourself and try it out. 9 times out of 10, those links are affiliate links. So one influencer marketing like program platform that I really like is Refersion. I believe it's $89 a month, and it's really easy to understand and kind of track the links and everything. Like, the interface looks really simple, so I would definitely recommend that one. And it connects to your Shopify account or big e-commerce, whatever you use for your business, it syncs directly to it. The setup process and everything is really simple and easy. Okay, and here is just another little small pro tip, something that you should be doing. So if you do not have your Instagram shop set up, you need to set it up. Now, I know some people don't trust shopping on Instagram or shopping on any kind of social media platform, but there is a growing number of people who do. I want you to think about it like this. A lot of people, we want things instantly. We want instant gratification, okay? We don't wanna have to hop through a lot of hoops, click a bunch of links in order to just purchase something. So you want to take advantage of the fact that people can buy directly from you in the Instagram app. You want to take advantage of that, one, because you're using a feature that the platform is pushing, the platform wants you to use it, so you're good there. And two, you may not think that a lot of people use it, but once you set it up and you start to see how many people are using it, you're going to realize how much money you were missing because you didn't have it set up. Okay, so I hope that this helps set you up for success for Black Friday and the holiday season. It can be really stressful to try to juggle promoting your products and running your business all at the same time, especially during the holiday season. So using influencers can help to alleviate this stress and help you hit those sales goals. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye.